It's AumSum time!
Why do astronauts wear orange and white spacesuits?
Because orange and white are my favorite colors.
No. The orange spacesuit is called Advanced Crew Escape Suit. Astronauts wear it during the launch and landing period. But why? Because if there is any malfunction during the launching or landing period and the astronaut has to abandon the space shuttle, this particular shade is the most visible color against any landscape, especially against the blue sky and sea, thus making it easy for the rescuers to spot the astronaut. Now, the white spacesuit is called extravehicular activity suit. Astronauts wear it when they go outside the space shuttle to do some work. It is white in color for two reasons. Firstly, in space, the astronaut is exposed to extreme heat of the sun, and white is the color which reflects more heat than any other colors, thus preventing the astronaut from getting too warm. Secondly, white color makes it easy to spot the astronaut against the black expanse of space.
Why is space black?
Cause somebody forgot to pay the electricity bill.
Nah. Our sun is a huge star, which emits a tremendous amount of light. However, like our sun, there are so many stars in the universe that counting them is almost impossible. So, if there are so many stars, the space shouldn't be black or dark, right?
Absolutely!
However, this is not the case. According to a study, the space appears black because the universe is expanding. This expansion is causing the visible light emitted by the stars to stretch out so much that when it reaches our eyes, they cannot detect it. As our eyes cannot detect any visible light, the space appears black to us. Moreover, light has a specific speed limit. So, light from far, far away stars has not even reached us. Thus, the space appears black.
Can we burp in space? I can burp in my personal space. Just kidding. Earth's gravity pulls food down, down, down. Where? To the bottom of our stomach. Whoa! Gases have begun to rise. And here they come. But space has no gravity. So, food and gases float together like junky bubbles. Now, what happens if we burp? Ew. Everything comes out. So, even if you can, don't burp in space.
Why is landing on Mars so difficult?
Because trespassing is prohibited on Mars.
Oh, listen. Before Mars, we successfully landed on Earth and Moon. Earth has a thick atmosphere. So, the advantage in this case is that we can use parachutes to slow down the spacecraft. While, the disadvantage is that the thick atmosphere creates frictional heating, thus requiring heat shields. Now, as the moon has no atmosphere, the disadvantage is that parachutes don't work. Hence, we need complex retro rockets. But the advantage is that no atmosphere means no friction, so no need of heat shields. Now, more than 50% of landings on Mars have failed because we face both the above disadvantages here. Why? Because Mars' atmosphere is 100 times thinner than Earth's atmosphere. So, parachutes are ineffective. Hence, we need complex retro rockets. Also, as the atmosphere is not completely absent, we need heat shields. As a result, the complexity of landing on Mars increases. What is a black hole? Usually, when a star is alive, the inward force of gravity is exactly balanced at each point by the outward force created by hot gases and radiation. These inward and outward forces maintain balance and hold the star together. However, when the star runs out of fuel, there are no hot gases and radiation.
Hence, there is no outward force to balance the inward pull of gravity, and thus, the star begins to die. The star's core begins to collapse under its own gravity. This collapse causes the outer layers to blow apart in a huge explosion called a supernova. Now, it is estimated that if a star has at least 20 times more mass than our sun, then the star collapses to form a black hole. The surface or boundary of a black hole is called event horizon. Nothing can escape from within the event horizon of a black hole, not even light. Hence, the black hole appears black.